Well, I did not want to do these episodes. I did not want to come out there and talk about an area that I feel highly deficient on, as in, I feel like I am not even qualified to talk about this. But the thing is that we've got to address this subject, one point or another. Listen, we're talking about the fullness of your personal glory as a man. Of course, this is in the middle of another series. A bigger series is personal glory. But now we've zeroed in on talking about the man, the male man, the father, the husband, the boyfriend, you get. And so we're discussing what are some of the aspects that will bring us to our full majesty, our full greatness, our full personal glory as male men. And that is in the background, at the backdrop of a world that is becoming too liberal, and a world that is, fighting for the so-called equality, which is not there, really, honestly. There's differentness, there's uniqueness, and so on. And so we're looking at how can we rise up to be the men that we are supposed to be. And I am not, again, saying that I'm there. I'm just heavy in the heart about this. And these things need to be discussed. So let's have one more listen. Stay tuned.
Welcome to the Life Signatures Podcast with Lawrence Namale. Lawrence is a life coach, author, and keynote speaker who loves to tackle different topics on purpose, productivity, and resilience. His mission in life is to awaken all your boundless possibilities available in you. Life Signatures Podcast is dedicated to bring to reality every single person who knows that deep down in their gut, there's got to be more to life than this. And now, here is your host, Lawrence Namale.
Well, we will need to still go back to the source when we're discussing aspects to do with nature. That's just about it. You are a natural human being. Whether you're male or female, you are a natural human being. And something about nature is the potential that it has to naturally be what it was supposed to be in the first place. Can you believe that? I mean, can you believe that we have to make a case for this? Something about anything that is natural. The fish doesn't clamor for its rights and says, I am trapped in this body that has scales. The ego doesn't clamor for its rights saying that I wanted to be a pigeon. Or I am a pigeon, I feel I'm a pigeon inside of me. And I'm trapped in this ego body with these feathers. With these mighty wings. It's nature. It's natural. You don't hear the lions doing that. And the elephants wanting to be trans animal. I'm going to get into trouble. The only people that do this are the crown of creation. The human beings. Those are the guys who do these shenanigans of equality and trans whatever and so on. And in the process, the personal glory of people, whether they are male or female, it is eroded over and over again. And so you look at the species of the male man around, and you look around to find out who exactly is a great man. And you start looking around and it's hard to find. And yet the seeds for greatness, the seeds for the glory of the man, the majesty of the man, they are existing within them. Our problem is that we're trying to redefine nature And by so doing, we're becoming a pale shadow of ourselves. If you look at the definition of a man today, you'll be shocked at what you're seeing. It's superficial. It's far from the seeds that are already available inside of the man. And therefore, the greatest desire we have for in this world, the greatest desire that men, the greatest desire that women have, the greatest desire that children have is for the greatness of the man, the glory of the man, the glory of the father, the glory of the husband. And there are various things that comes along with. But the most powerful ingredient of greatness is going to not run automatically. If I lined up all the ingredients that are going to make you the man of greatness, to make you to come to your full personal glory, if I lined up all the ingredients you needed, that doesn't necessarily mean that you're going to become a great man just like that. I might give you several aspects to build your greatness and glory as a man, but all those will hinge on one major thing, which is commitment to attain that level. This means that we must push ourselves, and we must want to push ourselves past our comfort zones in order to daily improve different facets of our manhood until we attain the full stature of the measure of the glory that God places inside of us. It is there. And let us not be distracted by several pursuits in this world. In other words, we must be willing and committed to work at it. We must embrace the discomfort and the improvement that comes with it. We must feel the shame and the embarrassment that could necessarily be overcome. And we must generally push our limits as men. There is theory, like I said in two episodes prior, and then there is practical. But practical has to be hinged on some kind of theory, some kind of philosophy, some kind of identity, some kind of knowledge. It also means that we must be willing to feel the pain as men. We must be willing to break the culture and the status quo. In fact, on a daily basis, the agenda that is unnatural is going to continue being pushed. I don't know why they are doing it, but they're going to continue pushing the agenda that is going to emasculate, as it were, philosophically, the man. And you look around, there is no majestic, great man within us or among us because of that. And we've got to continue pushing back. We've got to continue pushing back on things like real men don't cry. We've got to continue pushing against things like all men must cheat on their wives, and all men cheat, all men are dogs. We must continue to push against things like purity is not possible for men, and must continue to push against things like men were created with no power of self-control, and what a man can do, a woman can do also, and you know, all these things. If the greatness of the man is going to be realized, we must be willing to break the misconception that forces this so-called gender equality these forces are trying to create. Let me tell you this about gender equality, about feminism, and so on and so forth. All those things have a place. When people talk about a patriarchal world, they have a place, because over the years the women have been oppressed. And do you know why the women have been oppressed? Children have been oppressed. You know why? It is because there is lack of the full greatness of the glory of the man, the male man. And the more you try to make things equal, the more you try to squeeze the society and make things equal, the more you are emasculating the real man who can actually protect the woman, who can actually see the fullness and the extent of the glory of the woman and the child. Because that is his calling, that is his place, that is where he belongs, that is what he is supposed to do, that's how he's supposed to function. So all a man is needed for is to donate sperms, and that's just about it, and that all we are equal. Even as we are told that a man is the head of the home, in practical sense, the man actually is the foundation of the home. And I had this from Miles Monroe. We are the foundation of very many things. When you see things going amiss in this world, in this society, there's a way you can connect it to either the lack of a great man, or you can connect it to the misuse of the identity of a man, one way or another. And so we've got to be circumspect when you're talking about these things. We must push our limits. We must be focusing on being the man of greatness, the man of glory, the man of majesty. And we shall start seeing the simplicity of our greatness even as we do this. And it's just nature, just relying on nature. And we shall start feeling these things in our psyche. In other words, we shall start reaping the benefits of our greatness and the glory as men that God intended us for us to be. And we shall do that when we go back to the identity of the man. The man messed, the man fell, and therefore society is now clamoring for equality, is clamoring for this and clamoring for that because of the lack of great men. I do believe that if we had great men in their grandeur and in their majesty and in their glory, you will not be seeing the movement of feminism. You will not be seeing the movement and the clamor for gender equality. It is because the male man has failed in his place. That's why the woman feels deficient. That's why the woman feels used, and it's true. That's why the woman feels abused, and it is true. That's why the woman feels suppressed, and it is true. It is true because the greatness of a man is not existing. The majesty of a man is not existing. And that's why the woman has to pick it, has to go out there and fight for her rights. Will you believe that? But where there is a greatness of a man, you will not see a woman picketing. You will not even see a woman complaining. Never, never. You will not see this gender equality movement. You will not see it. Because the man knows his place, and his place is to nurture, to protect, to fulfill his agenda on the face of the earth. And that includes, and is not limited to, looking after the woman and taking care of her. And I know people say, oh, me, I'm a woman, I can take care of myself. That's okay. If you can take care of yourself and in your own world, that's fine. But you're living in a world that is having both genders, male and female, and both of them have their place to work, their place to operate. So I am not against anything here. I am just saying that we need the real men to rise up. And I'm talking to myself as much as I'm talking to any man out there. We've done this world a great disservice by not being men of greatness, men of full personal majesty and glory. We've done this world a great disservice by being a pale shadow of ourselves. We've done this world a great disservice by not being men of valor, men of purpose, men with a mandate, men who love, men who care, men who can be counted on, men who commit, men who stay. There's a lot of theory I've spoken about today, and one hopes that the practical aspects of this will start being seen in my life as well. It's easy to talk about men in general. Where the rubber meets the road is when I am the one being addressed as an individual. What is the fullness of the greatness of my existence? What is my majesty as a man? Is it there? Can my wife say it's there? Can my children say it's there? Can the community say it's there? Can my colleagues at work say it's there? Can God say it's there? Until tomorrow, bye-bye.
Thank you for listening to Life Signatures Radio. If you enjoyed today's show, subscribe to Life Signatures Radio on iTunes, Stitcher, or visit our website at lifesignatures.libsyn.com. Life Signatures Radio, fresh, clean, and inspiring.